Hi, I am S.Akila, working as assistant professor in the Department of Computer Science, Velalar College for Women, Erode. Now we are going to see about how to animate using PowerPoint. So we will see with examples one by one. First example, we will see how to color a text and draw lines for emphasis. Emphasis means for importance. So here in one box we have this objective, describe the text, conditions, behavior, standards in red color. And in another box we have underlines, but it is in a thick line. So we will see how to do this. So in the PowerPoint, you select the text which you want to emphasize and you choose that A option, and you can select whatever color you want. So this is how you have to give the emphasis. Then when you want to underline, you go to the format shape option. When you right click, you will get this option and you can click the line color. So in that you can choose the solid line so that you can get a thick line like this, and you can choose whatever color you want for emphasis. So this is how you can give the color text and draw lines for emphasis. So now you can practice on your own on how to color the words and how to draw lines using words. For next example, we will see how to add shapes and text boxes. So as an example, I have taken a picture, and in this picture I have to explain this particular part and this particular part. So this I have to show it as peace, and this I have to show it as strength. So like this. So when I click, so I am getting a circle there, and there a piece appears. And when again if I click, I get a circle there to denote the emphasis, and I have a word called strength here to denote that particular part. So how to do this in PowerPoint, we will see. So you have to first insert the picture, whatever your picture you want. So you can take it from your system and you can click the insert option, and you have to select that particular picture you want using this insert button. Then as a next step, so you have inserted a particular picture on the slide. Then as a next step, in the home page you choose the shape you want, whatever you want to emphasize this particular part. So you have chosen the circle, and then in the shape fill you can choose the color, whatever color you want, and you can fill the no fill option so that this particular shape will not be filled with anything, and you can change the color as you like it. So and in format shapes you can change the line style also. So width, you can change the width, that is the thickness of that particular shape, and then you can click choose whatever you want in this option. Then so you can drag that particular shape from that, and you can insert it in that particular picture. So now you want to denote this particular part as piece. So for that you can just go to the insert option, you click the text box. So here a text box appears, and you can type whatever you want in that particular text box. Similarly, you can show the other part as the same as that of the previous one. That is, here you can put the same circle and you can denote it using a text box. So now you can practice on your own how to give the emphasis on a picture. So add shaping and text boxes in a picture. Then as a next example, we will see how to hide and remove shapes. So see, first as an illustration, I will see how this particular picture appears. So when I click, so this particular axis, the axis appears, and then the y-axis appears, the information about the y-axis appears, then an arc is drawn, and then when I again click, it is showing that particular part of the arc. So here also. So this actually appears as if I am drawing in the particular hand, but I have done only hiding and removing the shapes. So we will see how to do this in PowerPoint. So first you draw this particular graph, whatever you want, as manually you can draw in the PowerPoint. Then you have to show it as a on click, you have to show that particular arc so that it may appear that it actually is drawn in the particular hand. So for that you can use the format shape option. In that you go and choose the solid fill, and in the color you can choose the white color so that it is hidden. So it all appears as a text box. Format shape, you have to choose in format shape. You can go and choose this particular option, this box appears. Then so you have used the animation. So you go to the animations, you choose this custom animation. Here a text box window appears, and in that you have the add effect option. In that, on exit means when you click. So on exit you have to make a fade there, fade in that particular part. So it becomes faded. Then when you click, it becomes, it appears. So this is how we have to add the effect for animation. So exit and then fade. Similarly for all the parts of the graph. And you can also give the directions whatever you want. So when you want to the arc to appear like this, you can give in clockwise. When you want to give in the anti-clockwise direction, you can choose the direction. So here I have chosen the direction. So from bottom, from left, from right and from top. So whatever directions you want, you can choose and you can give the animation. So here also, here you can see this custom animation toolbox. So as a next example, we will see how to insert multimedia. So see this picture. So this is one man's photograph and this is one picture and this is one message box and this is a speaker. So in this, when I click this, a song or whatever music will be displayed. So how to do this in PowerPoint? So here actually that box is called as a call out, and here a sound appears, photo appears and a movie appears. So you just go to the insert option and you can do all these things. It is already available in the PowerPoint. Then as a fifth example, we can see how to display list items sequentially. Sequentially means when you are taking class, then you have to explain point by point. So when you want to do this, you can do like this. See here as an illustration. So when I am clicking, the clean wound with antiseptic is appearing. Then when I am clicking the second part, the first part becomes blood. Similarly, when I click again, the first two parts become blood. So similarly, all the things. So finally, when I click, so everything is clear. So when you want to explain like this, how to do this in PowerPoint, we will see. So for that, you type all these things and as usual, you select the text you want and you go to custom animation and you can go to add effect and you can choose whatever. So when you enter entrance, if you want the effect to be coming in the entrance, then you can click. So on click. Similarly, emphasis, exit, medium parts. If you give, you can see the difference whatever it happens. Then similarly, you can do for all these options. So in this add effect, you have to go and click the entrance option. And in that you have many options. You can give it as fade. Fade means it will become fade when you click on it. Then the next one appears. Similarly, you can do for all these things. Then as a sixth example, we will see how to add a motion path. So see for this as an illustration, see this picture. So when I click, the parts of the picture appears and I again click, the ball moves from one direction and go and stops in that particular direction. So how to do this animation in PowerPoint? So let us see. So it is very easy. You just draw a path along with this, wherever you want this particular ball to be to go, and you draw this particular path. Then after drawing the path, you go to custom animation, change, in that you have motion path, in that you can click the draw custom path. Draw custom path means it will appear as we have drawn in that particular path. So you have other options also, left, right, top, down. So these are all already available. This custom path means it will move according to the path we have drawn. So in that you can choose the curve option. If you click this, then this particular ball will be shown that as if the ball is moving in that particular path. So this is how you can use the animation in PowerPoint. So you can just add a motion path to the ball. Thank you.